How is it to create a vector lotus flower inside Affinity Designer for the iPad? Welcome everyone, I am your host, Elias Antopoulos. Alright, so inside Affinity Designer, I'll start this off by first creating a reference point at the very center. So I'll make sure that the preview mode is on, my guides are on, and inside the guide settings, I'll add a horizontal guide and a vertical guide. Then I'll go ahead and grab the ellipse tool and just tap and drag to create an elliptical shape as such. No need to have any fill color, so I'm going to swipe up to remove that. And I'll set the stroke numerically to 1 point. All right, I'll make sure this sits at the very center. There you go. And I'll grab the node tool. I'll convert this to curves. I'll tap on this node, convert this to a sharp node, tap on that node, and convert that to a sharp node. So I got the first petal. Now I want to create another duplicate. So with the move tool, as I tap and drag, I'll tap two finger modifier into the canvas to create the second petal here. So inside the layers panel, I'll swipe to the right to select both of these curves, long press, I'll duplicate those, and inside the transform panel, first I'll make sure that the anchor point sits at the very center, and numerically, I'll set the rotation to 15 degrees. I'll double tap on the command controller and create a bunch of duplicates all around till it completes this circular motion, like so. All right, that looks great. Now let's look inside the layers panel. Now we have a bunch of curves here, which I'm going to group them. So I'll tap on the very first curve, and at the very bottom, with a two-finger tap, all of these layers will be selected, and to group them, I'll use a great gesture, and that will be I'm going to pinch inwards. Here is the first group. All right, so just in case I need to refer back to this, I'm going to long press, create a duplicate of this group, and then swipe to the left, lock this group, and make it invisible. So I'm just going to focus on this group now. And I'm going to actually grab the vector flood fill tool. And this way, I'm going to color some of these intersecting shapes. I have set my own lotus flower swatch here. So I grab this color and I start filling those intersecting shapes. Like so. Then I grab this color, this fill color, and color those intersecting shapes. Like so. All right, that looks good. Now we have, of course, new curves, and I'll do the same. I'll tap once to select that curve. I'll go all the way at the bottom, and with a two-finger tap, all the layers in between will be selected, and I will pinch inwards to create another group, which I'm going to swipe to the left and lock it. As well for this group, I will lock this one as well. And I'm ready to go to the next step and add some circles. So to create the circles, I grab the ellipse tool and then tap and drag. And as I do, I use a three-finger modifier onto the canvas to do this from the very center. I release that. No need to have any fill color, so I'm going to swipe up. And I'll set the stroke for now to be able to see what I'm doing to 1 point. And I'll center this right there. Okay, so for that, for this circle, I'll go ahead and add a gradient. So I grab the gradient tool, And by the way, Affinity Designer does come with predefined gradients. So I'll tap on that. That's a great beginning. Then I tap and bring this ellipse under this group to be able to see the gradients. And looking at the colors here, the first color stop will be set to white. The second color stop will be set to white, but I'll add one more color stop to the very center and set that to this color. Now, in between, I can drag this midpoint marker to adjust the spread of the colors between those two color stops. All right. So no need to have any stroke now. What I do need is to have another circle. So for that, a long press, duplicate this, swipe to the left to lock this ellipse, so don't accidentally move it, and focus on that. So for this here, I'll set, first of all, the fill color to be a solid color. Now I don't see it because I need to scale this up. So I'm going to start scaling and then add a 3-finger modifier onto the canvas, like so. All right, so we've got that. Now I'll add a couple of strokes, and I can do this inside the appearance palette. So I'll set the first stroke to 10 points. And for the color, I'll set this one to white. Back on the appearance palette, I'll add another stroke. I'll set this one to numerically to 8 points. I'll set the color to, let's say, this color, my choice. And then inside the stroke options, I'll set the alignment to inside. So I like what I see. I'm also going to swipe to the left to lock this one. And I'm ready to go to the last step and finish up the lotus flower with a lot of arrow petals. All right, so before I move on, there's one more thing I would like to change here, and that is on this group here, I'm going to set the width, the stroke width to 1 point, and change this color to white. Then I'm going to swipe to the left and lock this group so I don't accidentally move it. All right, I'm also going to have the preview on so I can see my guides here. I'll pinch in, grab the pen tool, and then tap and drag to create the first anchor point. And let's say I'm going to go right here, tap and drag to create the sinker anchor point. All right, now this, I'll have this color of my choice here. And I grab the node tool. I make sure that this sits a little bit on the inside. Okay, have a little bit of curve, and I'm using the node tool. Okay, so I like that. I'll go ahead and create a duplicate. So I'm going to tap and drag, and as I do, I'm going to use a 2-finger modifier onto the canvas, and then flip this horizontally. All right, these look good. Let me make sure that this sits right on top of each other. Great. I'll swipe to the right. I grab the node tool, and then I'm going to join them together as one curve. All right. So the next thing I want to do is actually offset the stroke and create a shape out of it. And the best tool for that is the contour tool. And I'm going to do this interactively, nice and slow, perhaps around here. All right. Now, with the contour tool selected, I'll make sure that I convert this to curves. I'll grab the node tool, and I'm going to bring this in, this node and this node. So both of these need to sit around on top of each other, all right? I think that looks good. A little bit here. Maybe there, just to make sure that this is a smooth path. There we go, that looks pretty good. And I'm going to select that and fill this with a color of my choice, this dark color, so it matches the outside stroke color coming from the circle. And inside the layers panel, I'm going to tap and drag this and bring out the very bottom so we don't see anything extruding on the outside. So I've got that. Maybe I can scale this down just a tad and just bring this in a little bit and inwards. So I select that, long press, create duplicate, tap and drag, rotate this 180 degrees, bring this in. Okay, great. So I'll swipe to the right, select both, long press, create a duplicate, and inside the transform panel, I'll make sure that the anchor point sits at the very center, and numerically I'll set the rotation to 15 degrees. And so I'm going to double tap here and continue creating a bunch of duplicates to go around the circle to fill up all the petals here. I believe that works pretty well. Let's see. Now, another thing what I can do here is group those, all these petals here. Two finger tap to select all of these. And then once again, I use the gesture to pinch inwards and group those petals as well. All right. So here is a way how to create a vector lotus flower using some great tools inside Affinity Designer.